Well, hello, West Coast Ranch Horse members and show exhibitors. So this is going to be a quick update video to the previous video you may have seen showing you how to create your account with EcoScribe and then register for shows. EcoScribe is the software platform we use to manage the show entries and then also show placings and results on show day. So without any further ado, I'm going to try to make this as quick as possible. My goal is to get you through this in 10 minutes. If you need to, you can always stop it and back it up. But if it's your first time going to live.equascribe.com, your page is going to look something like this. So what you want to do is click the entrant or payer, and then you're going to click the sign up button. From there, it'll take you to a page where you fill out all your information, including your date of birth, your address, and your phone number, and then you'll hit submit. Once you do that, it'll send you an email giving you a link to finalize your account and set up your password. So since I've already done that, I'm going to go back to the original sign-in page. I'm going to click entrant and payer, and then I'm going to click sign in. We're going to come back to that page at the very end because I'm going to show you a couple of things that will be useful come show day. I've saved my password. I highly recommend that you do that, whether it be on your phone or on your computer. On show day, it's really handy to be able to just jump in your phone, tap a couple of times, and you're right into your account without having to type a password or an email a bunch of different times. So I'm going to click sign in. Now it's going to take me to my account. This is the main starting point for everything. So the first thing you're going to want to do is go in here under My People. Now if this is the first time you've logged in, it's going to show you down here on this bottom line. Most important step that you need to take when registering, getting your account set up, is go in and get any person, including yourself, verified. So I've already done this right here where it says review complete. When you set up a new person, the button will look a little bit different, and I'll show you that here in a minute, but it will say request review. That's what you're gonna need to do in order to be eligible to show. What that allows us to do on the admin side is confirm that your membership is active, that you're eligible to show, and there haven't been any sort of issues that would prevent you from showing. Once we approve that, then you're good to go. So for the purposes of demonstration, I'm just going to click add. Now, one thing to note here, let's say, for example, you have a trainer that is showing a horse for you, but you want to do their entries because it's your horse and you don't want the trainer to have to mess with it. You can go in and search for this person. So, let's pretend for a minute that I'm a trainer and I'm going to search my name as an exhibitor. It's going to show me that exhibitor availability. Now, we're going to just pretend that we're going to add a new person straight off. So we'll click create new person, add their information. So we'll just we'll do test rider. And I'm just going to fill things in here so I can get past the requirements and show you this next piece, which is make sure you put your dashes in here. It does get a little grumpy when you don't have dashes in there. So we'll then hit save. As soon as I hit save on my person, add some more information here, add membership. Couple of things to know here. So if you want to add your West Coast Ranch Horse membership, you can do that just by clicking add membership. Then it'll give you a drop down which will give you all the available associations. The downside to doing this is you can put your membership type in, whether it be general or amateur. Almost all of ours are classified as general. Your membership number, expiration date. The thing is, then a membership card image is going to be required. So what you can do is just upload a picture of your horse or whatever. Since we don't actually issue digital cards, it's all done via email. You don't really need to mess with this if you don't want to, but if you decide to, great, awesome, saves me a step in verifying your membership. But regardless, the most important thing here is that you go down and click request review. When you click that button, it's going to ask you which organization. You then say West Coast Ranch Horse, and then you'd hit submit. Once you hit submit, it comes to us, I verify it, and then send it back. Most important thing to do, probably the most common thing that I see that prevents people from entering the show. So I'm going to delete that, undo the exhibitor, and we're going to go back. So then the next thing I need to do also is add my horse. Now I've added a couple horses here already, so I'm going to go in here and create a new horse. Now again, same thing. If you are leasing a horse from someone, potentially, you know, sharing a horse, anything like that, then you would want to go in and search this horse. And I'm just going to show you how that works. It's already one of my added horses, so it's not going to show that again. But you would search for that horse's name and then add them if they were had already been created in the system. If they're not, not a big deal. Just go in and create a new horse and go from there. So we're going to say test horse. But my typing is not very good today. I apologize. It does ask you for the full date. So we're just going to put in kind of a bogus date here. If you know the full date, that's awesome. Put it in. If not, just make sure you have it in this date format, day, month, year, and then save it. Even if you only know the year, that's completely fine. It's going to ask you, is it a mare, gelding, or a stallion? We'll just say this is a gelding. We'll say it's a brown horse and is solid colored. Horse height is required. We don't have any restrictions on horse height for us as an organization, but this software is used by by shows that, you know, have various different classes, including miniatures, and that does have a horse height requirement. So if we click that twice, it'll then toggle over to hands. We can say use 14.2 hands. Again, the owner, I can search myself and it'll show. But really, ultimately, you know, pick whoever the owner is, and all you got to do then at that point is again click save. So with the owner filled out, I'll just fill out myself here, and then we'll click save. So once we click save, it's going to add some more fields here. Very important, again, this request review button. Click request review, the organization, and then submit. And then we'll get those requests that come in. We verify the requests, and we are off to the races. Now, as far as registration goes, if you do have AQHA, APHA, any other of those types of registrations, add them in. You know, the more the better. Especially with AQHA, if we do have AQHA classes, we're going to require verification of that information anyway, so you might as well save it to the profile while you're doing it the first time. So all your information, then just click save. I'm not going to do that on this particular horse. So I will back out of that, and then I'm also going to delete this horse. So again, this just shows you how to delete the horse. We'll delete him out of there. Now we're back to the barn the way it was. Last thing I need to do before I enter the horse show, which I do just by clicking that horse shows button, go down to my account. I have two options under the My Account button. Change my payment method, or if this is your first time logging in, that would be add a payment method, or change my password. So you need to add a payment method, put all your credit card information in there, save it, it'll ask you to verify it, and then this is going to be saved on your account. So then at the conclusion of show day, any outstanding balance on the invoice would then be charged against this card. So I'm going to back out of that, and now we are ready to enter the show. So we'll go to horse shows. What I always do to make it easier to find the shows so they're organized by date is I click start date twice, and that gives me shows in chronological order. I'm going to go down here and say, no, we're looking for the San Diego Buckle Series, but the same process would be true if you're entering the Fall Buckle Series. I'm going to go over here and click the arrow over. Take a look at my entries. Now, I've already done some sample entries to test here, but I'll go back and we'll show you how to do this, the entries part again. Live invoice, just for your records, this shows all of the charges that you've incurred for any horses that are entered and associated with this account. And then your placings also is grayed out right now, but on show day, once those placings start to come in, that's where you can find those placings. The patterns tab, here's a copy of your patterns. Ultimately, those will get released about the day before the show. We'll get that uploaded. The pattern book's already posted on westcoastranchhorse.com, but regardless, there's another spot for your patterns. So now to add entries, I'm going to go click the entries button. Again, you know, we've got these three entries here, or these four entries here rather. I'm going to scratch out all of them. And scratching is just, you know, just as easy as doing this right here. Click the red X and you're done. So now to add those entries, I'll click add edit. It's going to ask me for the exhibitor, so we'll say it's me. It's going to ask me for the horse. Now, it's only going to show you the horses that have been verified and are associated to your account. One other thing that you can do in this system is you get to pick your own back number. So between 1 and 999 is the criteria. So we're going to say 101, and that number is available. Now, I know 100 is a number that has been used, so I'll just show you what it looks like when you type in a number that's already been used. So if we click 100, it's going to say, nope, that number's not available. So we'll go back to our 101 number. But again, any number, you know, a lot of people use their birthday. A lot of people use, you know, any number of reasons they use the numbers they use. But you get to pick your own back number. So then once we've got that all done, next thing you do is we go down and we pick our classes. So the classes are organized in order of the division. So first is going to be the open, then the amateur, amateur select, and so on. So if you look at these class numbers, they're not necessarily going to coincide with what is on the show bill. We're in the process of updating the show bills to reflect the same. But this first number is going to be the digit of the division. The second number is going to be the digit of the class. So division one is the open, and the second number being one is the ranch riding. So division one point, or I'm sorry, class 1.1 is the open ranch riding. Class 1.2 is the open ranch trail. Class 1.3, and so on. You get the idea. So then if we go down here to our amateur ranch riding, that'd be division two. Amateur select is division three. The youth is division four. Now each show is a little bit different, so you got to pay attention to how many divisions. If we're talking about the Temecula series where there's a limited division, you know, those numbers will be a little bit different. But let's say I wanted to show in the amateur division as a whole. I would go down here to division two, and I would pick classes 2.1, 2.2, 2.3, and 2.4. That's going to give me the amateur division in the ranch riding, the ranch trail, and the ranch confirmation. Then let's also say, hey, I decided I wanted to go in the open as a warm-up, then I could go up here to the open ranch riding and add that. Welcome to do that. All I've got to do then is click save. It's going to take me back and show me all the entries that I just processed, and that's it. And if at any point you want to add or edit those entries, all you got to do is click that add edit button. I'm going to go back to the show page. Again, our live invoice right here shows all the classes that I just added. As the day goes on, those classes that showed upcoming entries will then show as completed entries. And that is how you register for the show. Seems like a really long process. The initial, you know, getting the people set up, the horses set up, that definitely takes the longest amount of time. But once you do that for the first time, you don't have to do it again. And it's all right there in your account when you go back and save it. One last thing that I will show you, which is going to be very important on show day. If you log out of your account, so we'll go ahead and log out and go back, and I want to point out this view show status button. So what the view show status button, and this is new since the last show, view show status is going to give us a few things. It's going to give us our working orders and our placings. So if we were to look at our current shows, this is the show that's going on right now. We'll just go in there and I'll show you what it looks like. If I click that next button, it's going to show me working orders for all the classes. So in this case, they have two different arenas that they're working. And then it'll show me placings for all the classes that they've got going on at the same time. So we will back up here. I'll show you how it looks for West Coast Ranch Horse. So I clicked on future shows, but on show day, obviously you click on current show. We're going to say it's San Diego Buckle Series, and our working orders are right there. So what you can do in the working orders is go through, find your class. Again, they're organized by division. Find your class, and you can find your working orders for the ranch riding. Trail is work at will, but the ranch riding is what you'd be looking for on that. So new advancements, you know, even since the last show. Hope this was pretty straightforward and easy. If you have any questions, you can always call us at 951-595-7536 or send us an email at westcoastranchhorse@gmail.com. Look forward to seeing you guys at the show. And again, if you have any questions, do not hesitate to call. Thank you.